Hey, Canucks fans, I don't know about you, but I was very impressed with the debut of Jack Rathbone. I'm Clay Emo. I'm at Canuck Clay on Twitter. I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm the founder of the GLCPC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club. This is my Canucks take all in one take. It's Clay's Canucks commentary for Wednesday, May the 5th. This is where you get Canucks insight that's positive and timely. Shout out to my Hall of Fame members, Jens95, simalexander, Justin Incredible, nucksfan number 29, Lucas Gates, Chris Seifried, Adam Broomfield, the Shea Family Channel, and Jamie Sports Talk, and more. Thanks for your support, as always. And thanks to the support of all members of all levels. You are listed in my video description. If you want to become a member of the CCC Crew, simply press the join button underneath this or any of my videos or on the memberships tab on my YouTube channel. Thanks to everyone who joined me for my post-game live stream last night. Lively conversation. It was good. You know, sort of this resignation that the Canucks aren't going to make the playoffs, that they're doing their best. But I appreciate everyone who took the time to join me. And some good chatter about Jack Rathbone. That's who I want to talk about today. He made his NHL debut last night, just over 12 minutes of ice time. And he looked good. He looked really good. And Travis Green said so. From the eye test, it looked like it. Now, I get that he didn't have to play against McDavid and Draisaitl. You gave all those heavy minutes to Edler. So I get that. And I get that we shouldn't get too excited after simply one game. But I saw enough in Jack Rathbone's game where I think he can be, I think he will be a solid NHLer. And not just bottom six pairing. It's funny, when we talk about Olli Juolevi, who is a first round, fifth overall draft pick in 2016, when you talk about Juolevi, we use terms as hopefully he'll be a regular NHLer, third pairing guy. With Jack Rathbone, I've already heard people talking about him being a second pairing guy. Now, Rathbone was drafted in the fourth round, 95th overall by the Canucks in the year 2017. And as I've mentioned a few times on this channel, the Canucks have a chance to hit five guys from that draft year. Pettersson, DiPietro, Lind, Gajewicz, and Rathbone. Time will tell how much each of those guys will play. But five guys out of one draft class would be amazing. So fourth round, 95th overall, 2017 draft. We know he's smart. He goes to Harvard. We know that Harvard was one of the first teams to shut down about a year ago. So he's been on the taxi squad all year. So it's been a very challenging year for Jack Rathbone, just like it has been for many, many players. But, you know, I'll talk about his on the ice in a second. But even in his media availability after the game last night, he is so mature. And I'm not saying it's just because of Harvard. I think he's just a smart guy anyways. But his outlook, he's very mature. He's turning 22 at the end of this month. But he sounds like a 25, 26-year-old the way he speaks. But at the same time, he talked about almost like a childlike naivety, how excited he was and how nervous he was to play. But he talked about how quickly he settled down and how the guys, his teammates, were really good for him. Just saying, just have fun, save for the moment, remember this day, and play your game. So I loved his maturity last night. In his media availability, it looks like he's very mature when it comes to just the way he speaks, his confidence, and the way he's able to articulate himself. But on the ice, I thought he was great. I really did. He didn't look out of place at all. You can see why the things, some of the skills that people are excited about, the way he can skate, the way he has a good first pass, the way he can be an offensive-minded defenseman. And there's two plays in particular that really stood out to me from last night. One was in the second period where, and many people have talked about this, especially those people that have watched him a lot in Utica, where he does this fake slap shot and then he kind of dances around or dekes a guy along the outside. And we saw that last night. I don't know who he deked out, but he came down in the second period. He came down over the blue line on his left side, faked a slap shot, and then went wide, beat his guy wide, and set up a scoring chance. So that was a really nice play, and it showed good poise and good confidence. The other one he did, I wouldn't say it's as conventional, but you remember in the third period, he was coming down, again on the left side. He beat a guy tried to rub him out on the boards, he beat them, and then he beat a second defender with a quick outside-in move, jumped to the inside, and then got a shot away. I think it was his one shot on net. So that was really good. It showed his quick, you know, footwork and his ability to be shifty in a very small place. So the way I explain him, he sounds a lot like Quinn Hughes. And that's true. Not just because they're both American or whatever, but two left shot guys who can skate themselves out of trouble and have an offensive flair to them. So I've said this before, I would actually be okay, I don't know if it's early as next year, but I would be okay down the road of a left side of Hughes, Rathbone, and Yolevi. Hughes will be your top pair D-man, of course. Rathbone could be a solid middle pair, and then you have Yolevi bringing up the third pair. I like that, actually. And, you know, depending on what happens with Alex Edler, if he retires or if the Canucks can't work something out with him, there's going to be a spot on the left side next season. The question is, will Jack Rathbone be ready to seize that spot on a full-time basis next year? Will Ole Yolevi, by extension, be able to do enough to seize that third pairing spot next year? But I wouldn't mind a blue line next year of Hughes, Rathbone, Yolevi on the left, and then you still have Myers and Schmidt on the right, and maybe you bring in, no Nikita Trampkin, but maybe you bring in a Travis Hamonic for another year at under $2 million. So, you know, I don't mind that at all. I don't mind that at all. And I thought that Jack Rathbone had a really, really good debut. Once again, I realized it's only one game, and I realized that he wasn't, you know, facing off against McDavid and Draisaitl, at least intentionally. But you remember that one play, he actually referred to it as his welcome to the NHL moment. It was in the second period where it was him, and it was against McDavid and Draisaitl, 2-on-1, the two of the best players in the world. And then McDavid, so Rathbone says he was trying to take away the pass and let Demko have the shot. Well, technically, he didn't do either. Although he tried, Rathbone laid down, and actually McDavid's pass got over Rathbone's outstretched stick, but then it also went through Draisaitl as well. So there was no shot attempt at all. So you could say that Rathbone broke it up, but it was all in all, it's good that he could laugh about it afterwards. And and then the Oilers didn't score, at least on that particular play. They scored on a bunch of other plays last night, but we won't get into that. So that's exciting for me. To see Colin make his debut last week, Jack Rathbone this week, likely Jonah Gadjevich next week sometime. And we can see that the Canucks, as expected, are starting to work some of their young players in, knowing that they're not going to make the playoffs this season. And, you know, any time that they get in now, just puts them further ahead on their development curve. Now, the interesting thing, lastly, I'll say about Rathbone, I don't think he's going to play every single game the last nine games for the Canucks. I don't think Yolevi's going to play the last nine games for the Canucks, because they'll likely swap in for each other because, you know, they both play that left side and you have Hughes and Edler in front of you. So likely you'll see one or the other going for the last bit of the season. Then do you bring in Chatfield on the right? Well, if you do that, then you have to flop Schmidt over to the left, and then you're not playing Yolevi or Rathbone. So if it was up to me, I wouldn't play Chatfield for the rest of the year. I keep the right side, Hamonic, Schmidt, and Myers. And then on the left side, you go Hughes, Edler, and then you rotate, or two games each at a time, for Yolevi and Rathbone. Canucks fans, let me know what you thought about Rathbone's debut. Am I aiming too high for a second pairing spot for him as early as next season? Maybe it's down the road, or do you not even see him topping out as a second pairing guy? Let me know what you think in the comments. I would love to read, react, and reply. As always, subscribe if you like to. Like this video if you like to. Become a member of this channel if you like to. Stay safe, stay healthy, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and have a great day. God bless, and go Canucks go.